Funnily enough, I went into fashion because kind of the general idea was you couldn't make money from art. And so I decided, well, if I want to do something creative, I'll go into fashion. And so I studied both a bachelor and a master in fashion design. And yeah, I started a career after that in fashion. And I worked in fashion, I think, for 12, 15 years before I kind of decided to swap and kind of move flat and start being an artist. So every piece is different. I mean, the process starts usually with research. I mean, I do a lot of research, specifically in Italy, you know, Amsterdam, Holland, and Portugal and things like this. Mostly because I'm kind of inspired by, you know, the Flemish masters, the Renaissance and things like this. And the beauty of it all, you know, the greatness of the palazzo and, you know, the palazzi and things like this. And that's how it starts, you know, just collecting a lot of imagery, not only like on my phone and, you know, but also kind of in my head. And kind of after like a while you sit down and you don't know where the inspiration necessarily comes from, but it kind of hits you, oh, this is what I have to do. And so then you kind of try to make that your own somehow. Depending on the artwork, I mean, it's either, you know, it's either digital or it's kind of you start painting, either oils or acrylics. It's kind of, yeah, it's, that's how it kind of comes about. I mean, I'm inspired by everything that's out there, everything from street art to pop art to, you know, contemporaries to modern art. I'm inspired by, it's things that catch my eye, things that are beautiful, things that I find aesthetically pleasing and I can kind of uses inspiration and incorporates into my art, only if it's just a little hint, like a color possibly, or a little shape which no one knows, you know, that that was kind of comes from a Robert Indiana painting, and it's just this little touch, and you know, everything comes together and you kind of create something that is your own at the end of the day. Skulls and guns, I mean, it's the fragility of it all. So you kind of, you make something that's either dead or lethal into something beautiful. So you're kind of changing the preconceived notion that people have about something. So I mean, this is a red thread that goes through all my work, which even the portraits, for example, it's this thing about social media these days. You kind of try to portray this picture perfect image of yourself and your family and your friends. And you know, the more you see this, the more you kind of realize that there's something really seriously not happy with this person portraying herself or himself in this way. And you know, it's that kind of the theme of looking at things closer, not believing what you're being, not what's being put in front of you, and kind of changing the perception of it, really. So at the moment, I am working at, you know, I have quite a few projects going on. I have a project with a new apartment building in Manhattan in New York, which is called 19 Dutch, where I'm doing three pieces. One is kind of a 4.5 meter kind of, what should I say, old master-esque painting of two lions. As well as kind of doing the elevator cabs for the building, and also, you know, the crests, the shield for the building itself. Apart from that, I'm also doing, just started in talks to do an album cover. Will be my third album cover I do. And I will not mention the name until it's official and a bit out, or confirmed rather. And other than that, I have a porcelain skull coming out on the 26th, through Art Republic in Brighton. So that's you know, that's the launch is going to be on the 26th, and that's kind of a human human size skull in person, blue and white.